Ladies and gentlemen, while I hope you're already exploring the platform features, you are very much at Dell Technologies' presence, the Economic Times Cloud Innovation Summit, co-powered by Amazon Internet Services Private Limited. Well, whether you are new to cloud or an experienced user, you know, this summit is something that will definitely give you an impression and of course the technical knowledge for your journey into the world of cloud computing. So we are here to further brace you up with a special address as promised, and this is going to be pivoted around cloud transformation engine, the mantra to develop a world-class cloud strategy. But we'll be joined by a thought leader, ladies and gentlemen, whom you all know well. So without any ado, allow me to please rope in the National Cyber Security Coordinator from the Government of India. Allow me to welcome our distinguished guest, Lieutenant General Dr. Rajesh Pant.
Well, greetings of the day to all attendees of this event hosted by the Economic Times, and thanks for having me here for the Cloud Innovation Summit 2021. As we're all aware, the COVID pandemic has created a digital transformation. Everything has become online, all aspects of life, in fact, whether it's the government, whether academia, whether it's businesses, society, we've all gone online. And the adoption of cloud services has increased exponentially. With that background, I have been asked today to speak on the mantra to develop a world-class cloud strategy. At the outset, there is no doubt that cloud computing infrastructure is the backbone of the delivery pipeline of just about every digital service, from social media and streaming entertainment to connected cars and autonomous Internet of Things infrastructure. In fact, the cloud is a valuable way for governments to deliver effective and efficient services to their constituencies. And cloud has long been heralded as a catalyst for innovation and digital transformation, thanks to its ability to increase development speed and provide near limitless scale. One of the biggest benefits is that cloud technology makes every other technology lighter, faster, and more accessible from a customer point of view. And this fact will be a key driver in the migration of more services to the cloud platforms. As we can see today, every responsible business understands that it has a part to play in tackling the challenges of climate change. In technology, this often centers on reducing the energy usage associated with increasingly powerful computing engines, larger digital storage requirements, and the energy costs of providing a 24/7 always-on infrastructure services to customers. Thus, cloud is the ultimate optimization to reduce your carbon footprint. So what is it that companies should do? Firstly, I think companies should put in place a cloud-ready operating model. They should develop a cloud literate workforce, because it is essential that people develop the relevant skills and knowledge to contribute to and fully benefit from the cloud. Businesses should also carry out a cloud security posture management, a CSPM as it is called, because research has shown that misconfiguration, lack of visibility, identity, and unauthorized access comes under the highest ranks cloud threats. So cloud security posture management looks at the configuration of your cloud platform accounts and identifies any possible misconfiguration leading to data breaches and leakage. The cloud environment is dramatically expanding, and the identification of misconfiguration becomes increasingly difficult. In fact, Gartner identifies misconfiguration as the core reason behind data breaches. We must also see how to ensure customer data protection before it reaches the cloud. Businesses are highly invested today in encrypting data before sending it to the cloud. And it's not too late to introduce the concept of BYOK, or bring your own key encryption, for the overall benefit of the organization and customers. The BYOK encryption system encrypts the organization's data, and the access to the information lies with the owner. But businesses need to be cautious while introducing the system, as some plans upload the keys to the cloud security platform. This again makes the information vulnerable and prone to leakage. Furthermore, we should strictly follow the zero trust model. This offers complete security by assuring no one gets access to data until their identity is authenticated. It ensures the users get access only to the information that they need. No piece of extra information is offered in any scenario. At every step, the user gets to authenticate their identity. And this model gives the control back to the organization and increases accountability by providing limited access. The possibility of data breaches reduces. Adapting to this model becomes necessary with an increased number of insider attacks. And employees should never gain access to information that isn't relevant to their particular area. It may also be noted by the organizations that simply lift and shift applications to the cloud will not change in the architecture. They will miss out on key benefits such as auto scaling and automated performance management. Having seen these aspects, let us now see some of the modern trends in cloud computing. And the first is the rise of serverless. Serverless cloud is a relatively new concept that's gaining traction in the market. Sometimes referred to as functions as a service, it means that organizations aren't tied into leasing servers by paying for fixed amounts of storage or bandwidth. It promises a truly pay-as-you-go service where the infrastructure scales invisibly as an application requires it. Of course, it isn't really serverless. The servers are still there, but it adds another layer of abstraction between the user and the platform, meaning the user doesn't have to get involved with configurations and technicalities. The next trend is edge computing. This is an emerging cloud trend that involves building localized data centers for computation and storage at or near where they are needed. This offsets the load on the cloud and improves the deployment and running of a wide array of applications. Instead of relying on centralized networks, computing and management are handled locally. Then we also have the aspect of cloud security access brokers, or CASBs. They provide software that operates between the cloud users and platforms to enforce centralized security measures, implementing a consistent system of governance. And finally, we also have AI in the cloud. AI seems to be everywhere these days, and the development of cloud and AI are inextricably interwoven, and this will only become truer from next year onwards. Strong trends in AI will be creative algorithms, generative machine learning that can create anything from art to synthetic data to train more AIs, as well as language modeling. This increases the accuracy with machines can understand human languages. Cloud computing will certainly play a key role in delivering these services to users, as well as building the infrastructure to deliver them. These were some mantras I thought I will share with the community today. And finally, let me once again compliment the Economic Times for hosting this Cloud Innovation Summit. I wish the event all success. Thank you. Jai Hind.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, I do hope that you were listening to this session. And I would like to say a big thank you to Lieutenant General Dr. Rajesh Pant. I think, sir, hearing you empowers our avid learners out there. Thank you very much. And on that note, as we are just arming ourselves with more on the cloud, and before we actually enter into, yes, I must not miss on this one, we are entering into a poll segment, a quick one. This is going to be short, quick and easy. Allow me to admit, ladies and gentlemen, that cloud migration, when we talk about, is a complex process, so as to say. So you and I must know the best practices of seamless cloud migration. For that, I'm going to be urging all of you to visit the Software One booth in the experience zone. So that's something that looks like a virtual legwork. I'm sure everybody will indulge and visit the Software One booth along with everything else that you have to score. I'm sure you've by now checked on, you know, what all elements lead you to the leaderboard building up, right? I will be taking you through that shortly, maybe after the next session. But for now, I just want you to know that there is a poll that's coming up for which I will ask you to please participate in, all of you. So let's make that exciting that way. And of course, we'll be right back on the screen with the next session. And of course, some very, very exciting announcements. But after the session of redefining business resiliency for the new normal, and I call it the next normal. See you right there.